Teraz
jak to zrobić?
Miałem chytry plan na bardzo fajne ćwiczenie, ale jednak odwrócę się do mnie. Popatrzcie w prawo, w lewo, znaczy upewnijcie się, że znacie linię waszego prawego i lewego sąsiada. Powiedzcie, dzień dobry, mam na imię, a ty jak masz na imię? Thank you. niedawno przeszedł na katolicyzm, konwertował z protestantyzmu pastor, który założył ponad 1000 kościołów protestanckich na całym świecie, w tym większość na Syberii i w byłym ZSRR. Jest także Colin Sainz, pastor kościoła, wolnego kościoła chrześcijańskiego z Edynburga. Polecam, co jest ciekawe, jest to bardzo wnikliwa analiza trzech rozdziałów pierwszego listu do Koryntian, w którym jest zawarte 80% praktycznych wskazówek co do życia wspólnot chrześcijańskich. Także zachęcam i polecam do nabycia. Wydaje mi się, że najlepiej w stanie nie mógł zapytać, jakby ktoś był zainteresowany. To tyle o wstawiennicza trwa. Spowiedź już nie ma. Już nie ma. To tyle ogłoszeń. A teraz wspomniany wcześniej Tom Peterson. Tom Peterson po 25 latach został nagrodzony jako najlepszy menadżer do spraw reklamy korporacyjnej. To, co zmieniło jego życie, to łaska, którą otrzymał duchowego nawrócenia. Tą łaskę otrzymał podczas rekolekcji dla mężczyzn. Ten moment radykalnie zmienił. Dwa medialne stowarzyszenia. Jedno pro-life, Virtue Media, a drugie katolicy wracają do domu. Co jest ważne? Jak mówi Tom, ludzie, których spotykał, katolicy wracali do domu Ojca jako pierwsza grupa wierzących, która w ciągu ostatnich 10 lat emitowała reklamy w sieciach telewizyjnych. To jest bardzo ciekawe, ponieważ pierwsze stowarzyszenie wyemitowało najwięcej reklam. Wyobraźcie sobie, nawrócone życie jednego człowieka i w ciągu 10 lat 300 milionów ludzi otrzymuje przekaz. Mają stronę internetową, nazywa się Komando Komando. Jest ona dostępna także w języku polskim i jeszcze w innej 9 językach. To jest gospodarzem popularnego serialu telewizyjnego zatytułowanego właśnie Katolicy wracają do domu, który w tej chwili jest emitowany w trzecim sezonie. Jest emitowany w tak zwanym prime time, czyli czasie najwyższej oglądalności na żywo. Telewizji, której w Polsce jeszcze nie znamy, nazywa się FWTN.
Ja nie znam.
Wszystkich ślepo poproszę o wygłoszenie i poproszę o film.
Nasza rodzina zwana przez Ciebie godna każdym sprawy świata na wszystkich pięciu kontynentach. Dzięki Bożej łasce zdążyliśmy szpitala i drogie szkolecie Twoim. Zakładamy się rodzinicy nieustannie pomagać Tobie. Jesteśmy największą organizacją wegetatywną na całym świecie, jedynie pokojnie tym, którzy są potrzebni. Kształcimy więcej dzieci, że tak powiem, inna instytucja. Rozwinęliśmy nauki ścisłe i zdążyliśmy pierwsze na świecie uniwersytety. Prymy godności ludzkiego życia, odpoczęcia naturalnej śmierci i wspieramy tradycyjne małżeństwo. Prowadzeni przez Ducha Świętego skontynuowaliśmy Biblię. Jesteśmy pogmienieni przez Pismo Święte oraz świętą tradycję, które kierują nami od ponad 2000 lat. Jesteśmy Kościołem katolickim. Nasza rodzina liczy ponad milion członków, którzy łączą się w sakramentach oraz w pełni naszej wiary chrześcijańskiej. Odwiedź naszą stronę. Katolicy, powróćcie do domu. Prawda? Wieczorne godziny powietrze jest pełna cudowej radości, ponieważ nadchodzi święty Mikołaj. Ale poczekaj, w jego planie też jest przerwa. Każdy powinien mieć taki sam rytm jak święty Mikołaj. Mądrzy ludzie szukają wiele swojego Zbawiciela. Widzą, że tylko Jezus może ugasić największe pragnienie naszych serc. Wracaj więc na mszę świętą co tydzień, po każdym Boże roku, gdyż miłość i nasza nadzieja na niebo narodziły się dzisiaj. Spełniaj swoje marzenia.
They said to us, I needed to get right with God.
dzień nam muszę uporządkować swoje życie z Bogiem.
Confession is essential in our lives.
Spowiedź jest istotna w naszym życiu.
It helps heal our soul.
Pomaga uzdrowić naszą duszę.
It cleans our conscience. And gives us sacramental graces for the journey. Saint Teresa of Avila said this: Jesus has so many enemies and too few friends. That's why it's important for his few friends like us to be good friends. Confession restores that relationship with Jesus. So why does Jesus have so few friends? I think two things contribute to that. Spiritual warfare and lack of catechesis. I'd like to share a story with you of an example of this. A man named Murphy lived in Dublin,
Ireland.
Murphy was a gambler who liked to bet on the horses each day at the horse track. Murphy was losing terribly in the first two races. Then he saw a priest down on the field blessing a horse with the sign of the cross on his forehead. Murphy watched as the horse came in first place. Murphy watched the priest again. He blessed the horse with the sign of the cross on the horse's forehead. Murphy ran to the betting window and put 100 euros on that horse to win.
The
horse won.
The horse won.
The horse won. Then Murphy watched the priest again. The priest blessed the horse with the sign of the cross on the forehead. He blessed the horse's hooves on his feet. He blessed the horse's mane. He blessed the horse's tail. He blessed the horse up and down, right and left. Murphy, as a businessman, thought he would be a rich man, so he withdrew his life savings and bet all on that horse. How shocked and sad was Murphy when he saw that horse came in last place. He was humiliated as he went down to the field to talk to the priest. He said, "Father, what happened?" The priest looked at Murphy and said, "That's the problem with you darn Protestants. You don't know the difference between a simple blessing and the last rites."
You don't know.
I'm glad Joe translated. I tell that story because so many people don't understand misunderstood things in our church is the sacrament of confession. Like my friend Tomasz, who did such a good job this morning, my life was changed after Eucharistic adoration and confession on a retreat. I was an out-of-control businessman in Arizona. I was a crazy businessman in Arizona. I would drive 200 kilometers per hour in traffic. My pride was also killing me spiritually. Through God's grace, this retreat changed my life. The priest asked, "Will those men with the prayer language meet me outside in the hallway?" Here's that, the prayer language. The gift of the Holy Spirit. So I watched as the priest said, "We're going to pray over these men." When the priest had benediction, I went out to be prayed over. And while I was down on the ground, after the Holy Spirit entered me, I heard two words in my heart. Downsize, get small, and simplify. I knew what that meant. I had no time for God, and I had no time for any of you. My ambition and my goals were my God. Wealth and achievement can distract us from doing God's will. We business people need to be on guard. We business people need to be cautious. Pope Benedict teaches, at the heart of all temptation, Pope Benedict teaches, at the heart of all temptation is the act of pushing God away. At the heart of all temptation is the act of pushing God away.
Yes,
I'll start over. Pope Benedict teaches, at the heart of all temptation, the heart of all temptation is the act of pushing God aside. Because we perceive Him as secondary. That pride and ambition we can have as business people lures us like a fish on a hook. I had a young executive who used to work for me. Jeff took another job and I moved away. Years later, I heard that Jeff had a problem. I went back to Arizona and interviewed Jeff. Jeff and I talked and I said, Jeff, what does it do in your life? He said, I have ALS, Lou Gehrig's disease. That is a disease that will kill you within 3 to 5 years, guaranteed. What Jeff said next is what surprised me. He said, I thank God I have this disease. I asked why. He said, as a young man, I was doing all of the things wrong in God's eyes. I thank God for this disease because it saved my life. It saved my soul. Jeff and I went on to talk for 1 hour. It became a national television special. Because Jeff talked about the power of confession. He said with such wisdom as a young man and a young father of 4 children. That sin weighs us down from doing God's will. God doesn't need us in His salvific mission. He can do it Himself. But as a loving God, He invites us to be part of this mission. Like a crucifix, we have that personal relationship with God. But like the cross beam of a cross, Christ calls us to love each other to heaven. Jesus calls us to love each other to heaven. So you see, sin keeps us from doing the mission that God wants us to do. Your mission field is different than mine. You work in a different company than I do. You live in a different neighborhood than I do. So you can see why God needs more friends to do His holy will. We can't have it both ways. On my retreat, God taught me that I had 1 foot in the world and 1 foot in God's world. Jesus calls us to give our whole hearts to Him. And when we do, the adventure begins. As a result of not going to confession, we live a life of duplicity. Duplicity is a fancy Catholic word. That means being two-faced or torn inside. The best way to explain the meaning of this word is to talk about an icon, a Russian or a Greek painting of the Last Supper. If you look at an icon of the Last Supper, you will see that Jesus and 11 of the apostles, you can see both sides of their face.
Możecie na niej zostawić jako 11 apostołów, chcę widzieć po części twarzy.
But not Judas.
Ale nie Judasz.
You only see one side of his face.
Widzicie jedną stronę twarzy.
Why?
Dlaczego?
He's hiding something.
Ukrywa coś.
That's how we feel when we don't put a confession. We're torn inside because we're not who God created us to be. God doesn't want us to lead a separate, split life. He wants us to be detached from this world. If you see a little bird, something as simple as a little thread can keep that bird from flying. I experienced a lesson in detachment one day when I was at a traffic light. If you know my history as a successful, rich, young businessman, you'll know that I was addicted to nice cars. I idolized cars. So years later, after my retreat, after going to daily mass, I was tempted to look back at my past life. So at the traffic light, I noticed a brand new Lexus car next to me. It was gorgeous. It was brand new.
Nothing.
So I started playing a game with God. And I did all the talking. Here's how it went. Lord, that car is very nice. I think I've been doing a good job for you lately. You are a father who loves his children. Notice that God is not getting a word in. I'm doing the talking. I even let him know that it was in Blessed Mother blue color. Then I really pushed the limit. I said, God, if you don't want me going shopping for that car, I want you to make it abundantly clear to me, like a board in my head. The light turned green and I went to get my hair cut. As I was waiting to get my hair cut, I looked through automobile magazines because I like cars. I found a magazine cover where maybe God gave me the answer to my question. How surprised I was when I pulled out the magazine and the headline read, Satanic Lexus. I think God gave me a clear sign I did not need to buy a new car. If you're driving a BMW, a new Mercedes, or a Lexus, I would love to look at your car and have a ride. But don't be embarrassed and wait to leave last.
nie końca pochowany i nie czekali na końca.
Cars were my area of detachment that I needed to work on.
Samochody były tym obszarem, w którym musiałem pracować nad tym odcięciem, odczepieniem się od świata.
We all need to ask God in our heart.
Wszyscy musimy pytać Boga w naszym sercu.
What do I need to be detached from?
Czego potrzebuję, od czego potrzebuję się odciąć, odczepić?
We can't have one foot in God's world and one foot in the secular world.
Nie możemy mieć jednej nogi w świecie Bożym i drugiej nogi w świecie sekularnym.
We need to give all of our heart, mind, soul, and strength to God.
Musimy oddać wszystko, umysł, serce, duszę Panu Bogu.
Theologians warn us.
Teologzy ostrzegają nas.
To be on guard for sin.
Strzec się przed.
Especially when we are hungry,
szczególnie kiedy jesteśmy głodni,
angry,
zmęczeni,
lonely,
samotni,
or tired,
albo zmęczeni.
In English, it spells halt, H-A-L-T, halt.
W angielsku to się skraca do stwierdzenia halt.
Like stop.
Jak stój.
Hungry, angry, lonely, and tired.
Głodny, zmęczony, samotny i zmęczony.
We must be on guard.
Musimy się strzec.
We can't let venial or small sins.
Nie możemy pozwolić grzechom powszednim lub małym grzechom.
Overwhelm our lives.
Tak zdominować nasze życie.
Because even the small sins can grow to bigger sins.
Nie można pozwolić grzechom powszednim lub małym grzechom.
A good way to think about this.
Dobrym sposobem na myśli.
Is a display of military aircraft.
Yes, that samolot wojskowy.
Flying in formation.
Lecącego w formacji.
If one plane veers off course.
Jeżeli jeden samolot zmieni kurs.
All the planes crash into each other.
Wszystkie samoloty się pozderzają.
Our sin affects our souls and those around us.
Nasz grzech wpływa na nas i na osoby w naszym otoczeniu.
Sometimes we choose things that are good for today.
Czasami wybieramy rzeczy, które są dobre na dzisiaj.
But not the greatest good.
Ale nie największe dobre.
A high school teacher wanted to teach his students a lesson.
Nauczyciel z liceum chciał nauczyć swoich uczniów lekcji.
He gave them a choice. I will give you a penny that will double every day for 30 days. Or I will give you $10,000. Which would you choose? Most young students would want the sure thing. They would choose the instant gratification. They would take the $10,000. But in doing so, they would be settling for 10,000 times less than a penny becomes as it doubles every day for 30 days. When it becomes $10.7 million. The teacher went on to tell the parents. How often do we do the same things in our own lives? We settle for something good. But not the greatest good. We want good things on the earth.
Wybieramy dobre rzeczy, chcemy dobre rzeczy na tym świecie.
But we take our focus off heaven.
Ale zdejmujemy naszą uwagę z nieba.
How many of you parents take your kids to soccer practice, football practice?
Jak wielu z was rodziców bierze swoje dzieci na piłkę nożną, na inny sport.
But we don't bring them to mass.
Ale nie bierzemy ich na mszę świętą.
He teaches us all a good lesson.
On uczy nas
to keep our eyes on the prize of heaven.
Abyśmy abyśmy mieli oczy skierowane na grobę w niebie.
So many people, especially young people,
tak wielu ludzi, szczególnie młodych ludzi,
don't think it matters to do everything right.
Myślę, że nie ma to znaczenia, że sobie dobrego czynić.
They often tell me that advertising and movies,
czasem mówią, że reklama i filmy,
the industry that I've been in,
przemysł, który byłem,
don't affect them.
Nie wpływa na nich.
They can pick and choose what they see and what they bring in their heart.
Mogą wybrać i robić to, co przynoszą do serca.
So I will give you a sample of this now.
Więc dam teraz przykład.
Let's turn the lights all the way off, please.
Proszę włączyć światło.
On each of your chairs, I left an ink dot. Could you please pick up the ink dot that you found on your chair?
Proszę włączyć tę plamkę, którą zostawiłem na oczy.
I would like to do a little experiment with you. For the next 30 seconds,
przez najbliższe 30 sekund,
the length of one television commercial, the length of one television commercial, the duration, I want you to stare at this ink dot. But I want you to hold it properly. Put the flat white part on the top. And you will see a triangle in the middle. It's white with four black dots.
Okay,
do you see that? Stare at those four black dots for 30 seconds and don't take your eyes off of it. Starting now. Okay, I'm going to talk for 30 seconds in time to you and stare at the picture only. At the end of the 30 seconds, I will tell you what to do. Keep staring at those four black dots. And don't take your eyes off the picture. In about 10 seconds, I will tell you what to do. At this point, I want you to close your eyes and tilt your head back toward the light. Close your eyes and tilt your head back toward the light. Who or what do you see?
Jesus.
If you don't see Jesus, perhaps you need confession. I'm just kidding. If you don't see Jesus, try it again. But keep your eyes closed as you tilt your head back. Show this to your teenagers tonight. On how what we take in with our eyes can affect us later. You see, what we do take in the business world can affect our lives later. It's very important for us when we receive God's mercy to then share God's mercy. After my retreat experience, I began to pray, and a priest told me to pray every day to lead someone closer to Christ. So I started going to daily mass, and I decided to say that prayer. Dear Jesus, use me to help lead someone closer to you today. I tell you the truth that the very first day I said the prayer, a little Vietnamese lady tapped me on the shoulder after Mass. She said, "Will you help my son Jimmy? He's been away from church for 20 years. I thought, man, is God
there?
He wasn't so good with the winning lottery ticket for me. But he wanted me to do his work. So the old lady and I stepped out to the back of the church. She said, "Please talk to my son Jimmy, who has been away from church for 20 years. But don't tell him his mama sent you. No boy wants his mama meddling in his life." So I said, "Where do I go?" She said, "He works at a nail store." I'm a dumb guy. I thought she meant a hardware store. But no, she meant a fingernail salon. So here I am as a businessman in my suit, walking into a women's nail salon. I had never evangelized before, and I didn't know what to say. So I walked in, and Jimmy was the only one there. I said, "Are you Jimmy?" And it didn't start off really well when he said, "Who wants to know?" So I said, "Somebody who loves you, God, and I want to invite you back to the Catholic Church." You could have heard a pin drop, it was so quiet. Then Jimmy said, "I don't need church. I find God in nature." And I told him, "We can find God in nature, but God brings us in community to help love each other to heaven. Lest you think I was successful, I was not. Jimmy did not come to church with me that day. Jimmy didn't come to church the second time I invited him. He said he would, but I stood in the back of the church all alone. But the third time was the charm. Jimmy called me on the phone on a Sunday morning. He said, "What mass is your family going to?" I said, "We're going to 11 o'clock. He said, and surprised me, "I want to go with you." I said, "Why would you finally come to mass?" He said, "Everything's changed." I said, "What do you mean?" He said, "Today I went fishing, and I fished a crucifix out of the water." He said to me something very profound. He said, "Do you think it was a sign?" I said, "Of course it's a sign. It's not just a cross, it's a crucifix." Jimmy did show up to mass that day. If you've ever gone to mass in Arizona where it's hot, people wear short pants, summer shirts, and flip-flop shoes, sandals. But not Jimmy. Jimmy showed up to church in black dress pants, a white collared shirt,
jasną skórę,
a tie,
kawat,
and polished shoes.
I buty tak na.
He looked more like a Mormon missionary.
Wyglądał jak Mormon misjonarz.
Who forgot his bicycle?
Który zapomniał swojego rowerka.
Then he did a Catholic boy.
Nie, a nie katolik.
But Jimmy remembered. I told him he needed to go to confession.
A Jim pamiętał, że powiedziałem, że musi iść do spowiedzi.
So the priest started mass later by telling the music director to wait.
Więc ksiądz zaczął tego dnia przy świętą później.
And he heard Jimmy's confession.
I wysłuchał spowiedzi Jimmy'ego.
Jimmy was a good man.
Jimmy stał się dobrym człowiekiem.
Fast forward 3 months.
I przeszedł pierwsze zdjęcie 3 miesiące.
Jimmy met the girl of his dreams.
Jimmy poznał dziewczynę swojego życia.
A Vietnamese girl that he was going to marry.
Wietnam, którą miał się ożenić.
6 months later they had a wedding.
7 miesięcy później się ożenili.
And the only words I understood.
Jedyne słowa, które zrozumiałem.
Were amen and hallelujah.
Były amen and hallelujah.
Those are the same words in every language.
To są takie same słowa w każdym języku.
Couple of days later, Jimmy came to my house.
Kilka dni później Jimmy pojawił się w moim domu.
He said, I need to talk to you in private. He didn't want my wife and my 3 little girls to hear him. In the kitchen, he said, I have something to tell you. He said, my mother and I are so thankful that you invited me back to confession and the Catholic Church.
My mama and I are so thankful that you invited me back to confession and the Catholic Church.
I said, no big deal, I'm happy to help.
Żadna sprawa, cieszę się, że mogę pomóc.
And Jimmy said, it is a big deal.
I Jimmy powiedział, to jest żadna sprawa.
Because you don't know the whole story.
Ponieważ nie masz całej historii.
I said, what do you mean?
Więc spytałem się, co mam na myśli.
He said, Tom.
Powiedziałem, Tom.
I was in federal prison for 20 years.
Byłem w federalnym więzieniu już 20 lat.
I was in the Asian mafia, the mob.
Byłem w azjatyckiej mafii.
No. I committed felony crimes, capital crimes against humanity.
Dopuściłem się strasznych zbrodni przeciwko ludzkości.
And I was arrested in Los Angeles and put in prison.
Zostałem aresztowany w Los Angeles i wstawiony do więzienia.
He said, I tell you this.
Powiedziałem to, co powiedział.
Because in prison.
Ponieważ w więzieniu.
People had time. And took the time to talk to others about God. In our busy business world, when we're trying to maximize profits, accomplish more, and achieve our objectives, we don't take time to tell others about God. He said, thank you for sharing the good news with me. It changed my life. I didn't feel pride then. And I don't feel pride about it now. I felt convicted in my heart. I suddenly thought of how many Jimmys were out there that I didn't talk to in a business meeting. That I didn't help when he was at a grocery store. Those sins of omission, those opportunities where the Holy Spirit put someone in front of me, that I should and could have helped, but I did nothing. My brothers and sisters in Christ, how many millions of Jimmys are out there that are waiting for you and I to share the gospel? But we're not doing it. We rarely talk about sins of omission anymore. In Matthew, we read about the Sermon on the Mount. Jesus teaches us in the Beatitudes It goes beyond just the Ten Commandments. Not just what we shouldn't do,
nie tylko to, co my powinniśmy czynić,
but moreover, what we should do out of love.
To, co powinniśmy czynić w prostej miłości.
See how lives are changed.
Zobaczcie, jak nasze życie się zmieniło.
When you and I step out of our comfort zone,
kiedy wchodzimy do strefy komfortu,
and we give God our all,
i dajemy Bogu naszą całość, całe nasze.
It all begins with the sacraments of confession. And then inviting others to God's healing mercy. They've done surveys. And most Catholics feel they can be a great Catholic. Even if they don't go to confession one time a year. We know that. The venial sins in our lives are helped by frequent confession. Are helped, are eliminated, or reduced by frequent confession. The benefits of frequent confession help us to know ourselves better. Help us to better understand our temperaments, our weaknesses, the way we're wired. The devil has made custom-made fishing lures, and his bait is individualized for each one of us. The devil has made custom-made fishing hooks, and his bait is custom for each one of us. We need to be on guard of that. St. Augustine said it so well when he said, "Know thyself and thy faults, and thus live." Know thyself and thy faults, and thus live. When we better understand how we're created and our weaknesses, we can avoid from tripping. We can better see the obstacles in front of us. St. Augustine would know this because he was a wealthy party boy. His mama, St. Monica, prayed for him for many, many years. Maybe most of us are praying for a child away from the church too. But we must never give up on them. There's a story of a prospector who used to look for gold. He was working a gold mine in Arizona in the mountains. He found a golf ball-sized nugget of gold. But after 3 weeks, he found no more. So he gave up the fortitude. He lost the fortitude and the will to go on. And he walked away from his claim. But the next dusty prospector who came along found the largest gold strike in Arizona history, 1 foot from where the first guy left off. God calls us to have fortitude, to never give up, to keep our eyes on heaven, and pray every day to lead someone closer to Christ, and never stop praying for our loved ones away from the church. A holy priest taught me a good way to do this. He said at Mass during consecration, put the loved ones in your life into the precious blood of Jesus. In other words, put them in the chalice that the priest holds up. He said, name them on your hands. So put your friends and relatives on your hands and put them in the blood of Jesus. We can help their souls for eternity by doing that. We need to be on guard for the things that trip us up. Oftentimes our talents are exactly what the evil one goes after. Let me explain. If we're given the gift of speech, our tongue can be usurped or used by the devil to be critical or judgmental to others. To speak with a sharp tongue towards someone else. So even though God gives us the gift of speech, it's like a double-edged sword where the devil goes after that gift and tries to steal it for himself. So also think of not only your weaknesses, we must think of our strengths. Because oftentimes the devil will use our strengths, especially in business, to cause us to stumble and fall. We become too prideful, too sure of ourselves, and then the evil one gets in. In conclusion, I will remind us that we should all frequent confession more often. Then, we need to have evangelistic hearts. And invite others to this healing sacrament of God's grace. This is my first time in Poland. I've always thought of Poland as a very holy country. We've known for years there are more Catholics here than perhaps anywhere else. But how sad I am to learn that so many, especially the young people, forgot about God. It breaks my heart. I recall a Bible passage out of Ezekiel. I won't quote it word for word, but I will give you the general interpretation of the Bible passage. God said to Ezekiel, I've made you a watchman over the house of Israel. Give them warning from me. If you do not give them warning, I will hold you accountable. But if you do give them warning, and they do not listen, then it is on them. That's not the exact quote, but it's close. I'm here to tell you that much good news has come from God's grace upon Catholics come home. We've seen lives changed in an instant. We have a television program going into its fourth year. I host the show and interview people.
prowadza szkołę i przeprowadza wywiady z ludźmi.
Who have come home to the church after an invitation like Catholics come home. One lady was born in Chicago. She was Catholic in her young days. But by the time high school came, she left the faith. She went to the University of Michigan during the 1960s. It was a time when radical hippies were in the United States. She became radical. By that time, she called herself an atheist. She met a young man that she wanted to marry who was also an atheist. So she got married to him, finished her doctorate degree, and went to teach communists in China how to speak English. She said, for 53 years I was an atheist. I said, Dr. Sampson, you have children. Did you pray for them during those years?
Pani doktor Simpson, ma Pani dzieci, czy modliła się Pani za nich te lata?
Did you pray when someone was in an accident?
Czy modliła się Pani, jeżeli ktoś miał taki wypadek?
Did you pray at all during those 53 years?
Czy modliła się Pani w ogóle w czasie 53 lat?
To my surprise, she answered.
Dla mojego zaskoczenia ona powiedziała.
Not even once.
Nawet nie ani razu.
How shocked I was that somebody didn't pray when they had hard times in their lives. But she was that far lost from God. She lost God, but he didn't lose her. Finally, I said, you're on my program, so what happened? And she said, I saw a television commercial. I thought, those Catholics are advertising. I think they're crazy. But she saw a second and a third and a fourth commercial. Her curiosity piqued her interest. And she went to the internet to look at our website. Through God's mercy, she came back to the church through the confessional. Now she's in an international prayer group in Vancouver, Canada. I asked her at the very end of the show, what is new and different in your life now? And here is what the former atheist of 53 years told me. She said, all I want to do is evangelize. We must never give up on our loved ones who are far away. We must never doubt that God's mercy for us is endless. No matter what we've done or where we've been, our loving Father is calling us home. And He's calling us to be a Catholic family. Here are a couple easy ways to start. When I began my talk, I said, Jak si masz, how are you? I don't know what you said back to me, but it was probably, I'm okay, I'm good. I propose we change what we say as a response. When someone asks, how are you? Let's answer, I'm blessed. Now, if you're from Atlanta and around Southern Baptists, Some of them might get a little excited. And they would say, I'm blessed. But we don't need to do that as Catholics. We can keep it very simple and quiet. And say gently, I'm blessed, how are you? That one change can make a profound difference in evangelization. Here is way number two, you can try. When someone tells you their problems, and everybody has problems, ask the person, how can I pray for you? But don't just ask them and leave. Because what happens? We forget to pray for them. So I propose we ask, can I pray for you right now? Three things happen when we do that. Number one, you remember to say the prayer. Number two, they feel the love that you said the prayer. And number three, the Holy Spirit reminds us to pray for them again, the next day and the next day. Here's way number three you can start to evangelize and share God's mercy after confession. I have a box of cards by the exit door. Enough for each of you to take a few with the Polish website for Catholics Come Home. If you keep them in your purse or wallet, you can share them with people who say, I used to be Catholic. Or perhaps they have a problem in their life and will realize God can help them. Here's way number four you can help. There's about a dozen Catholics Come Home books in Polish left at the bookstore. Pick up a copy and read it. It's not a book for your relatives who don't go to church. It's a book to empower Catholic business people like you. To feel more comfortable in sharing the faith. It's not a how-to book like a professor would write. It's an easy read with lots of stories. The last way you can help. Like the Bible passage out of Ezekiel, God is calling us as leaders of industry to take the wonderful knowledge from these speakers over the last 2 days, the wonderful joy from our great music, and the sacramental graces from confession, and bring the good news to the world around us. Share the faith with someone. Please consider having me back to speak to other groups in Poland. And please pray and try to open doors for us to put these evangelicals on television. If you and I don't promote the Catholic faith, Poland will lose its Christian identity. A city not too far from here called Berlin. Where I'll be tomorrow. Is the most secular city in the world. The vast majority of Berlin has no faith. They had faith at one time. The same thing can happen here if we're asleep. I'm going to end with this thought from a priest. His name was Father Mark Beard. He was a former business executive that became a priest at age 40. Here's what he said. If we aim for purgatory, as so many Catholics do, and we miss, what do we have? We have hell. So let's aim for heaven. And if we fall short, we at least have purgatory. My brothers and sisters in Christ, God loves you. And if someone comes up to you tomorrow or the next day and asks you, how are you? How will you respond? Jesus heard you say that, so don't disappoint him. Don't forget. You will feel the first 10 times when saying that like you're wearing your left shoe on your right foot. But do it anyway. It will then become second nature to you. God loves you, and spread the faith of Jesus to Poland.